aujourd'hui nous allons commencer la leçon numéro 3. Okay, so good morning students. Today we are going to start lesson number 3. Okay, we are going to start from the grammar parts. Okay, so in this grammar parts we have the afog des adjectives, the agreement of the adjectives. Okay, so we already saw in the previous book the link with the adjective. Okay, the agreement for the noun to the adjective. Okay, so we are going to see step by step how to link and have the agreement with the adjectives. Okay, so now I am starting with making an adjective feminine. Okay, so first you have making an adjective to feminine. Okay, generally an adjective takes a e. Okay, generally an adjective to add a e to the masculine form. Okay, so normalement nous avons un nom masculin, nous allons ajouter un e. So we are going to add a e to the masculine noun adjective. Okay, so here it is your masculine singular adjective, feminine singular adjective. Okay, so I have given you 3 examples for that. So you can see grand, haut, court. Okay, so you have the meaning of this also. Grand means tall, okay, big, or haut means high. Okay, so next to court, sharp. Okay, so you will have the meaning in your book. So you can take page number 32. Page number 32, you have the list of adjectives. Okay, you have the adjective in masculine, feminine, singular, feminine, plural, and you have the English meaning. Okay, so you have the English meaning along with that. You can see line by line you have the English meaning. You have to take page number 32 for that. Okay, so you can see in your book, and then we are going to add a e. You have the masculine column and you have the feminine singular column also. So grand, we are going to pronounce as grand. We are going to add a e. So we are going to pronounce that e, grand. Okay, so and next is o. So you can see my pronunciation and my tone. O, so we are going to add a e, so we type that will come oat. Okay, so court. Okay, so you can see the difference that I made for masculine and feminine. Grand, haut, court. Okay, it is clear. So on va passer à la deuxième partie. We are going to go for the next one. If the masculine form of the adjective ends with e, it remains the same. So if the masculine adjective end with a e, it remains the same. So we are not going to make changes for that. Okay, so jeune means what? Young. Okay, jeune. Rouge means red color. These are the adjective colors of adjective. Rouge, beige. So what is beige? So it's a nationality. Okay, so beige means, for example, I am Indian. Okay, so je suis Indien. Okay, so Belge means from the country Belgium. Okay, so if someone is coming from Belgium, we are going to say il est Belge or elle est Belge. He is Belgium. Okay, so il est Belge, elle est Belge. So Belge means a nationality. And for this also you have in page number, take your book in page number 29. You can see the countries. Okay, so les pays masculin et féminin. So they have added a e for the feminine countries and for plural also. Okay, so they have added a s for the plural countries. Okay, so you have to take page number 29 to refer the nationality of the countries. Okay, so go with that for the exercise. And facile means easy. Okay, facile, difficile, difficult. Okay, so I have given you basic words. Okay, so it remains the same in feminine also, masculine and feminine, when it ends with the e in masculine. So, J'espère que vous avez compris. I hope that you have understood this adjectives and we are going to go for the next one. The feminine of certain adjective is formed by doubling the consonant of the masculine form and adding a e. Okay, so you have the masculine adjective. Okay, so I have given the adjective from your book itself. Okay, so you can see in your book also. Gho, gho means fat. Okay, gho. Ba, ba means low, low. For example, the table is low. Lata means ba. Okay, so bon, bon means good, bon. Ancien, ancien means old. Okay, Indien. So you can see here also a nationality will come. Okay, so Indien means Indian. Gentil, gentil means kind. Okay, so gros, bas, bon, ancien, Indien, gentil. So we are going to double the consonant, the last letter that will come from for the adjective. We are going to double the consonant and add a e. Okay, so I have given you the answer here. So you can see gros. We are going to pronounce gros. Bas. So as I told you, la table bas. If the adjective, the noun is feminine, we are going to use the feminine adjective. We are not going to use masculine adjective. Be careful with that. Okay. So the adjective agrees with the noun. Okay. In the sentence, gros, bas, bon, ancien, and bien. For example, I am Indian. I am a woman. So I am going to tell je suis Indien. Okay, I am Indian. For example, if the boy is there, il est Indien. So we are going to use only masculine. For the feminine, we are going to double the consonant. Okay, so next, gentil. Gentil means kind. So if a boy is kind, we are going to use gentil. Il est gentil. If a girl is kind, we are going to double the consonant and write. Elle est gentille. Okay, so it will be very easy for you if you are learning the things that are the column that I told you, page number 32, adjectives. Okay, you will have the English meaning along with that. So it won't be any problem for you to write the assignment. And then we are going to go for the last part. An adjective ending with E-A-U. An adjective ending with E-A-U. That means the sound O. Okay? In the masculine form, change into L. E-L-L-E. Okay? To get the feminine form. Okay? We already saw the basic noun. Adjective. O. Nouveau. O means handsome. Okay? Or beautiful. For a person, we actually handsome. And for a things, we are going to say beautiful. Okay? So, beau, belle. Beau, belle. Okay? For masculine place, we are going to say beau. And belle for a feminine. Nouveau. Nouveau means new. Nouveau means new. So, we are going to change into nouvelle. Okay? So, for a feminine adjective. Now, and be careful for that. An adjective like beau, nouveau, vieux. Vieux means old also. Okay? So, vieux means old. So, we saw ancien, vieux, very old, old man. Okay? We are saying. An ancien noun we are not going to say. This is for a noun, this is for a person. Okay? So, vieux, and vieux homme, and vieille homme. So, change into belle, nouvelle, vieille. Okay? So, when it used before a masculine singular noun using with a vowel. As I told you, and vieille homme. Homme means a man. H-O-M-M-E. Okay? So, we are going to use and vieille homme. We are not going to say and vieux homme. Or I am giving to you another example also. An apartment. Okay, it started with a A. Okay, it's a bubble. So, un bel appartement, we are going to say. Okay, so we are not going to say and go up after one because it started with a vowel. Okay, so we are going to say and bell up after one. Okay, and bell up and bell hotel. Okay, so we have many things that we are going to change. Go, move over here into bell, bell, yeah. Okay, we are going to learn step by step for this. Okay, so this is the basic things of the agreement of the adjectives. So I am going to give you some exercise. Okay, we are going to do your assignment learning the nationality page number 29 and adjective page number 32. So with that we are going to do some exercise. I am going to give you and you are going to learn and write your assignment. Okay, so j'espère que vous avez compris. Okay, so vous allez avoir des exercices à faire. Merci.